This video is about MAPS. MAPS stands for Modeling Applied to Problem Solving, and that's the pedagogy that we're going to be using in this course. Now, pedagogies don't just fall out of the sky. They're designed for some purpose. And fundamentally, those considerations start with what we want you to learn. And so what is it that we want you to learn? I think basically, in one word, it's summed up in expertise. We want you to become an expert and to think about problems in mechanics like an expert and to solve them like an expert. Now, I've said solve problems, not get the answer. And that's a big, important distinction. Probably in high school or wherever you learned physics before, you concentrated on finding the formula and getting the answer. To become more expert-like, you have to think, how do you approach the problem? You need to have a systematic approach, and you need to be able to plan a solution. And finally, once you've gotten the solution done and you have an answer, you have to, and this is very important, you have to check whether your answer is sensible. And these are important things, especially this latter, because all of these skills, the skill to be systematic about how you solve problems, the skill to analyze whether the answer makes any sense at all, are important in other courses, they're important in life. Besides thinking like an expert in your approach to problems, I'd like you to think, as most experts do, that what this subject is and how it works is really elegant. It's really beautiful on some level. The idea that you can take just a few axioms, basically F equals MA, take some mathematics and extend that, and then find that over a wide range of physical problems, you can get a precise answer, an answer that's good to a part in 100,000, that's really, really accurate. That's really pretty amazing. And on top of that, what you find in this process of extending F equals MA systematically is that new concepts like angular momentum or linear momentum or energy emerge. And these concepts can be incredibly important. I might point out that you pay for energy in our society, but you don't pay for force. Now, let's get to modeling applied to problem solving itself. What is this method all about? There's basically two components, two legs upon which this thing stands. The first thing is we're going to give you a systematic way to model problems, to approach new problems and figure out how to solve them. The second feature is that when you're solving them, you will use a hierarchy of models. You will have arranged your existing knowledge in a form where it's easy to figure out which of it you want to apply to the problem. So in this hierarchy, you will classify energy and momentum and dynamics and angular momentum and energy all in a very uniform way that shows the similarities and the difference between these different core concepts, and which enables you to have easy access in modeling these things. Now, the systematic way for modeling new problems involves fundamentally, and right at the beginning, our procedure, which you'll hear an awful lot of, called systems, interactions, and models. And that helps you represent the problem in a way that you can decompose it and apply the core models. We also want you to learn whether the answer is sensible, whether it's reasonable, and finally, when you've gotten the answer, we want you to learn to suppress your normal tendency to rush on to the next problem and to back up and just think retrospectively, what did I learn when I solved this problem? How did I organize the knowledge that I already had to deal with this unfamiliar situation? When you use the MAPS method in problem solving, the key is modeling the problem, and the approach that we take, or that you will take, is to basically remember SIM. SIM stands for the standard approach in MAPS, and it's system, interaction, and model. Now, each of these terms has a pretty technical definition, And let me elaborate. The system is that part of the universe that you're going to consider. It involves two things. It involves the objects or the object that you are going to isolate from the rest of the world. And it involves what variable or variables you're going to use to describe that system. For instance, the velocity or the angular momentum or the energy or any one of the standard physics variables. The second important thing is the interactions. Interactions, physical interactions like gravity, contact force, generate forces on the system. And these forces and the type of forces that they are crucial in the third stage of basically this process, which is the modeling process itself, the SIM, the model. And basically that is to figure out and to pick which model is involved, which of the core physical models are, which is or which ones of them are involved in this particular problem. And specifying in advance the system and the interactions generally leads you to one or maybe two models that you could possibly apply, and hence it greatly simplifies figuring out which general approach and ultimately which particular equation, is operative in the system. So this shows two students in our class applying the MAPS system or the SIM system to a problem, and they're really going about it in a very sensible way. First of all, in the top left, they draw a picture of the object. It's a ball or a puck on a string that's going around in a circle on what I judge to be a frictionless table, and there are some numbers that specify the initial state of the system. So just looking at that picture and those numbers next to it, you can understand what the problem is that they're trying to do. Now, this problem must involve a final state that's different from the initial state, because they've drawn another picture just below it, and that picture shows the ball having been pulled into a smaller radius. So that's the pictorial representation of the problem. It gets all the words and symbols and maybe the picture on the page into one place, and it enables them to get that problem in their heads. Then they say, okay, what is the system? What is the system we're talking about? And they write down, well, it's the ball that's going around on the string. Then they say, what are the interactions? And they write that down too. And they're writing down only the relevant interactions. So they're, for instance, ignoring the gravity and the normal force of the table back up on the ball. And then finally they're saying, which of the main physical models do we apply in this case? And they've selected angular momentum. So this is the basic idea, and it may be that this problem also involves energy, so they'll have to write down another model, and then they can proceed to write down the equations for changing momentum and changing energy, and maybe decide that momentum is conserved or energy is conserved, or they're both conserved. But now they're in a position, having recognized what the concepts are behind this problem, to actually solve the problem in a fairly straightforward way. And that's basically what the SIM method or what MAPS is all about. It's making a systematic approach to the problem that leads in a natural and concept-based way to the equations that ultimately solve the problem.